going on, guys? The SSN back again with another video. That's right, boys. I'm back. Back better than ever. And not only am I back, I'm back a married man. That's right. That's why I've been gone for the last few weeks. I'm sorry that I haven't posted at all, but things have been super hectic, super crazy. But I'm married. I went on an awesome honeymoon. I had such a great time with my wife now, which just feels so strange to say. And on top of that, cherry on top of the cake, I don't know if you guys can see, gotta rep the Dolphins, baby. Gotta rep the Dolphins. Super pumped. I'm super excited to be back making some content for you guys. And before we get into the video today, as you guys can see from the title above, we'll be talking about what the Dolphins should do at that number three pick. A couple of announcements. Actually, really just one announcement. I'm gonna start switching up how we do things on the channel. I'm gonna start mixing up the way that we put out content just to keep it more consistent, more creative, just get you guys more stuff so we can keep locked in to Dolphins news, even NFL news in general. So what I'm gonna be doing, I was kind of brainstorming and I was talking to a couple of people and both of them had the idea that I thought was really awesome of, hey, you know what if we started just doing one video a week that was a little bit more in depth and longer, and we could dive deep into the analytics and the stats, so, you know, whatever, a lot of analysis. And every other day, instead of doing longer videos, you could just do kind of short clips, you know, little pump outs here and there of some updates, news, opinions, articles, whatever. And then we can, you know, really kind of add to that discussion down below in the comments section. That way it keeps me engaged. It keeps you and guys engaged. And I'm not pumping out like 30-minute videos every time I post. So probably be a little bit easier for you guys too. So that's what we're going to start doing on the channel. I think it's going to help a lot, help keep everything way more consistent, and it's gonna get you a lot more content to keep up with. So if you guys are excited about that and you haven't subscribed down below yet, hit that subscribe button. We're almost to our first 1,000 subs, which is awesome. As soon as we hit 1,000 subs, I'm gonna look into getting merch for you guys, which I already have for myself, a couple friends and family too, but I'm gonna start pumping out merch as soon as I possibly can when we hit that first 1,000 subs. And then also, guys, like the video, comment, hit the bell icon for notifications if you want to be kept up to date with all of the updates, news, all that stuff. And in the future, we'll be doing stuff like mock drafts and stuff like that too. So, all right, let's go ahead. Now that the updates and announcements and all that stuff is out of the way, let's get into the video. So this is going to be a shorter video. Be pumping out our first of like the little updates, opinions, those kinds of things. And like I said, a lot of the discussion is going to happen in the comment section below. So be sure to be active down in the comments so we can talk and kind of create some discussion down there too. So, all right. So as you guys can see from the title, talking about the third overall pick. Now, this is under the assumption that there is no trade for Deshaun Watson. This is under the assumption that we're sticking at that number three pick. So whether that was because the Dolphins couldn't come up with a trade, couldn't find a suitor, or decided they just didn't want to move down from number three and they liked their options on the board at the third overall pick. So let's talk about the third overall pick. Let's talk about what's on the board, what, you know, the Dolphins could do, and what direction I see the Dolphins working towards. So this is going to be kind of like a two-part video. This first part today, we're going to be addressing what if the Dolphins at the number three pick decide we want to get Tua weapons. That's our number one concern, is giving him as much to work with as possible in the passing game so we can air the ball out more, make him more comfortable, give him more pieces to work with, and just hopefully expand his game to a more consistent performance on a week-to-week basis. So if that's the scenario, and then next week I'll be addressing some other scenarios too, or next video even, probably not next week, it'll probably be sooner than that. But for this video, we'll talk about getting Tua weapons. So if I'm sitting there at number three overall, we can only assume Trevor Lawrence is going to go number one to the Jaguars. Number two, I think, is where the draft starts. All right, the Jets have a lot of options. They could do a lot of different things. But ultimately, I think they go with a quarterback. I think that quarterback is Zach Wilson. That's who I believe they will take. I think he has tons of upside, a lot to work with, huge arm. I think he's going to fit the system really well in New York. So that's where I think New York is going to trend towards, is drafting a quarterback. So at number three, if we're talking about let's equip Tua with all the weapons possible, it's got to be wide receiver. I don't think there's any other question. If we're talking about let's give Tua the most to work with right now, it's got to be wide receiver. So who are we working with at wide receiver? Who do I think is the best option? Who do I think is the best fit for the team? I want you guys to let me know down below who you think is the best fit for the Dolphins. So clearly, I think we've got three wide receivers who are the top, you know, the top of the class right now, the cream of the crop. They're the best in the country. You're probably not going to find many wide receiver prospects better than these guys. So first things first, we have someone like Devontae Smith from Alabama. Had a ridiculous year, 23 touchdowns, over 1,500 yards. Unbelievable. He had a fantastic season with Alabama, won the Heisman. He's the third wide receiver ever to win the Heisman. He just had such an incredible year. I mean, he was really, really talented. He has that familiarity with Tua. He has a familiarity with how Tua likes to play. He's used to the left arm throwing, if that's really even a factor to you. But that's our first option. We've got Devontae Smith on the board. Next, in my opinion, the best wide receiver in this class, Ja'Marr Chase. Now, I think a lot of people are suffering from recency bias. People forgot about Ja'Marr Chase and how explosive, how incredible he is. And in my opinion, I think he's the best wide receiver in the class. Unbelievable off the line, unbelievable in space, got a great vertical, he can high point the ball better than almost anybody, great hands, good route runner, he's just a total complete package at wide receiver. The only downside to someone like Ja'Marr Chase, for the Dolphins especially, is he's not extremely fast. He's not slow, and he doesn't have this massive frame. He's not like Preston Williams, who's going to run like a 4.6. But he is probably going to run somewhere in the 4.5s. I don't think he's super fast, probably won't put up a 4.4, but he does have a lot of the intangibles otherwise that make him a very successful receiver. I think he operates better on the ends, better on the boundary, but he could, you know, flex to the inside. I think he is a very versatile wide receiver. So you got a lot of options with someone like Ja'Marr Chase. That's why I think he's the number one option. And then the third wide receiver in the class, obviously, Jalen Waddle. Really, you could argue between any of these guys that they're the best wide receiver in the class. It could be 1A, 1B, 1C. Any of those guys could be, you could form an argument, a strong argument. This guy should be the number one. And Jalen Waddle is certainly in that discussion. He's extremely talented, extremely fast. This guy will run in the 4.3s, if not even lower. I mean, he is amazingly fast. He does a ton after the catch with the ball. He operates well in space. He's a good route runner. He's got decent hands. There's not a lot of, you know, weak points to Jalen Waddle except for those injuries. He does have some injury concern. So at the end of the day, assessing, all right, these are the options. This is what we're sitting here with. Who's the best fit for Miami? In my personal opinion, that could differ from a lot of people. I think that Jalen Waddle is probably the best fit for Miami at wide receiver. Coming out of the class, I think he profiles best for the Dolphins. The biggest question, though, is he's not worth the third overall pick. I think to a lot of people, looking at the wide receivers, looking at the Dolphins' condition, Jalen Waddle is probably not the third overall pick. I think he's going to be there a little bit later. He might, and I doubt it, but he might even be there at 18. Now, that's a stretch. I feel like he's going to be gone before then, but he could potentially be there at 18. So I'm almost taking him off the board just because of if we're stuck at the third overall pick, I'm probably not spending that on Jalen Waddle, considering that he'll probably be there later, considering the injuries, considering all of those things. So it leaves me between Devontae Smith and Ja'Marr Chase. And if I'm having to decide between those guys, I'm going Ja'Marr Chase. I think he's got more versatility. He's more complete. He offers a lot more, at least in my opinion, as a wide receiver. And the main downside, in my opinion, to Devontae Smith, he's a very small frame type of wide receiver. He's very skinny. He's not much heavier than me, and I'm skin and bones. I'm a stick. So Devontae Smith being as small as he is, going up against heavier cornerbacks, heavier safeties, heavier linebackers, that's going to be a struggle. And if he puts on that weight, if he gains 25 pounds, 20 pounds, 15 pounds even, which still is not very heavy, he's going to lose some speed. So I think Ja'Marr Chase in his current condition is better than Devontae Smith right now just because he's already got that weight, he's not slow, and he offers a totally complete game at wide receiver. And I think that helps Tua out a ton, especially considering Devontae Parker is getting a little bit older. We're going to start to look forward to the future beyond Devontae Parker pretty soon here, at least in the next year or two. And when Devontae Parker's on his way out, someone like Ja'Marr Chase can start to shift in and really become that number one guy for Tua, and he might even be right off the bat. So that's my personal opinion, guys. That's my short take for the day. Let me know what you think down below. What do you think if the Dolphins were sitting at number three and the decision was to get Tua as many weapons as possible, who would you go with at wide receiver? Devontae Smith, Ja'Marr Chase, Jalen Waddle? Let me know down below. If you'd even go in a different direction, let me know down below and we'll get talking, guys. Appreciate you stopping by. Looking forward to some new videos very, very soon. I'll catch you guys as soon as possible. Take it easy, guys. Have a great night. And as always, fins up.